Milton Crabapple. You know, it was me that talked Ludlow into getting into the radio business a long time ago. I told him I didn't think he was going to be able to make a living as a hairdresser. If you want to talk to him, you can call him at 1-800-572-TALK. Now that's 1-800-572-8255. And now, here's that girl turned Ludlow.
Well, a good morning, fun seekers. Hi, y'all. Great day. Little chill in the air this morning. No, not a touch of fall. But a preview of a touch of fall. Going to be a nice day today all over the southeast. And son of a gun, I feel good. I hope you do too. I hope today is going to be the best day of your life. Anything on your mind bothering you today, I want you to sit back for the next 3 hours and see if we can't make it better. At least make you feel better about it. We've got a lot of things we're going to talk about. But the main thing we want to do is have you here with us. 1-800-572-8255 is our number. And let me tell you some things we got on the menu today. And a lot of them. Anybody out there know whatever happened to Rula Linska? Denny, you don't know what happened to Rula Linska, do you? Rula Linska was the lady that used to advertise Alberto VO5, and they would put her on the screen and say, famous English actress. And nobody had ever heard of her. And then they stopped running the commercials, and nobody heard of her again. Whatever happened to Freddie Kilowatt? Remember Freddie Kilowatt? Gone. Whatever happened to Little Lulu? Denny, you remember Little Lulu? I know what happened to her. Little Lulu is now 58 years old and works at a Jiffy Lube in Fayetteville, North Carolina. That's where Little Lulu is. And one of the things we'll talk about, remember Little Lulu? Started advertising Kleenex after all those years as a cartoon character. Started advertising Kleenex in the funny papers. Did a great job. Little Lulu. Not a little boy's comic strip. More of a little girl's comic strip, I guess. But she had a boyfriend named Tubby. She was not allowed to join his club because they had the big sign outside the club that said no girls allowed. Remember that? Well, so much for Little Lulu. Do you remember? And our children need to know about this, particularly the little guys. Do you remember about your childhood vacations? Altogether different than they are now. Altogether different. You remember striking out in the car, going from wherever you live to Florida, or someplace where there was a beach. Do you remember all the Stucky signs? Do you remember B. Lloyd's? B. Lloyd's, which was a big competitor of Stucky's. Incidentally, B. Lloyd's is still in business, and they handle pecan products, and they're doing very well. But B. Lloyd's and Stucky's were big competitors. And as you rode down the road, not the expressway, but as you rode down the road, see one Stucky sign and one B. Lloyd's sign, one Stucky sign and one B. Lloyd's sign. And sometimes they even built these Stucky's and the B. Lloyd's right across the highway from each other. You could go from one to the other or not. Big competitors. The Okefenokee. Remember, we always pass the Okefenokee on our way to Florida. I think the only way to get there was to go through Waycross. Well, that's the only way we knew. The Okefenokee souvenirs, the little boxes that you'd buy for folks back home, little jewelry boxes as souvenir of the Okefenokee swamp. Yeah. Jacksonville Beach. Remember leaving early? Some people always like to leave on vacation early. I never figured that out. They will ruin a whole day because they're so tired when they get there. But in those days, there was no air conditioning. And the line from whoever was the driver or whoever was in charge of the safari, the line was, got to leave early before it gets hot. Remember along the road you saw things that says, tourist courts. Ever stay in a tourist court? A tourist court, normally a little bitty place, sometimes in a private home, but usually little wooden cabins out someplace. And we always packed a lunch, never left to go anywhere without a lunch. Yeah, you know, I guess it was a matter of economics, but the favorite lunch for our traveling was sausage biscuits, ham biscuits, or a variety. It's a He didn't have to stop. We'll talk about those and how they have changed. And how if you go on vacation now with your child and they don't have the a private room in a motel, they get insulted because they think that you're poor and you can't afford them. And that's probably right. 1-800-572-8255. Then I want to talk about your all-time favorite movie animal. Think about this now. Lassie, Trigger, Asta. Remember Asta, the thin man's dog? Remember the shark in Jaws? Great movie animal, the shark in Jaws. Remember Daisy from the Dagwood movies, Dagwood and Blondie movies? Daisy's probably my favorite. And there's Champion, the Wonder Horse, belonged to Gene Autry. Remember the giant squid from 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea? All of that. All right. We're going to talk about all of that and a lot more. Let me tell you how you get involved in this. It's 1-800-572-8255. 1-800-572-TALK. Ludlow Porch and Denny, the producer slash director of this whole thing. And we both want to hear from us a call.
In the kitchen.
Fun now. Just read something interesting in the paper. I'll tell you about it in a little while. Now, it's not going to knock your hat in the creek, but it's interesting. 1-800-572-8255 as we go to the phones and talk to my buddy Freckles. Good morning, young lady.
Happy Tuesday.
And to you.
I tell you what, you've got the knack of rattling my memory cage like nobody else.
Oh, good.
First of all, I believe it was Reddy Kilowatt, not Freddy Kilowatt. I think it was
okay.
Reddy.
Okay, you're exactly right.
My daddy worked for Georgia Power, and he used to have those little pins, you know, one Reddy Kilowatt, a little bolt of, little red bolt of lightning or something.
Yeah,
and had those little lapel pins. I probably could go to my mama's and dig around some drawer and find one somewhere.
I'd like to have one if you do.
If I go next time, I'm going Saturday, I'll go look for one.
Yeah, listen, before you start, can I tell you something I thought I'd read, just I thought very funny?
You certainly must.
Then I'll give you all the time you need. I was just glancing at the paper here about one of the elections, and second District Congressman Charles Hatcher from Georgia is chairman of the House Peanut Subcommittee. Wouldn't you? I'd rather have a social disease than be chairman of the House Peanut Subcommittee.
What the heck is a House Peanut?
I don't know, but it just struck me funny. Poor baby, somebody saddled him with that. That's awful.
That struck you funny like that squawking chicken strikes me.
Yeah.
Every time he does that, I go,
yeah.
Talking about family vacations, like I said, you started talking, and I went back how many years, lots of years.
Your eyes glazed over.
Yes. I was on the road again. When I was in grammar school, I was in the West End Elementary Band.
You wasn't.
Yes, I was. And we used to go to Daytona every year. The week after school was out and played in the band shell. And when we first started going, Lord have mercy, when I think about it, there was no air conditioning. And we'd pile up in a car, I don't know how many families and friends. I never will forget riding back one time on a pile of laundry sitting down in the floor.
Yeah.
And we stayed in a house. It was not air conditioned. And, of course, stopped at every Stuckey's along the way, if we could get my daddy to stop.
He didn't
like to stop.
Did you remember B. Lloyd's?
Oh, yeah. In fact, I had this little mind game that I played with B. Lloyd's. Now, this is stupid. And, you know, anything to pass it down. We, of course, we played cemetery game you played? You counted? Cow poker.
Yeah.
I'd say B. Lloyd's, Lloyd's, Oids, Woids, Doids. I didn't talk.
You know, I talked
dumb
about...
Dumb thing.
I didn't know they were still in business. I talked about them a year or so ago on the air as my memory was conjuring up one of these things.
Uh-huh.
And they sent me some pecans and said they're alive and well and having a big time. So they're still out there.
Well, we don't travel the back roads anymore. Nowadays, you go freeway. Because I grew up going to the Atlantic. Well, I grew up going to Daytona. And
yeah.
In later years, we've switched over to the Gulf. So we go down to small family beach this side of Panama City. In fact, we're going the end of August. But, Lord, my mom would get up and fry chicken on the morning we were to go, and we'd stop at a roadside park and eat fried chicken and deviled eggs and mom's biscuits.
What time did you leave?
Oh, 3:30 in the morning. And always, my mother would say, every time, I can hear her, we'd get on the road, and of course, the car wasn't air-conditioned. Well, I'm glad it's overcast now. We don't want it. We want it to be overcast because
right.
It keeps it from being so hot.
Keeps
as long, yeah, as long as it'll be overcast all the way down there.
Keeps the tires from being hot. Remember that?
No, she didn't talk about tires. She just talked about keeping us from being hot.
My mother used to say, I'd say, do we have to leave at 3:30, 4 o'clock? She said, well, you don't mind getting up a little early. I said, Mama, you don't understand. I'd rather die than get up early.
What is sleep in the car? Oh, no, I was always... As my friend's mama said, I was always journey proud. I couldn't wait to get up and leave.
Yeah, not me.
And I had an uncle, once, like I said, with a whole, my first cousin and I, he was also in the band. And we used to swap around and ride with them, or they'd ride with us. And I had an uncle who never opened his mouth except to growl. And he was one of these who'd do this spitting routine.
Yeah.
He did that one day out the window and landed right slap in my face.
I hope you found some kind of curse to put on him.
Well, I think he brought his own curse on him.
Yeah, okay, well, that thanks them to level themselves out, don't they?
Yeah, he reached around one time to grab my cousin and got me by the head of the hair. I don't know how we all survived those long trips, because I'm so hot-natured. I hate to be hot
yeah.
with passion.
I know folks now that still leave early.
Oh, we do. Oh. We leave early, even though we get there too early. That's
insane to get there so early. You got to wait for them to get your room ready.
Well, you're right. We've never had to wait. We were in a house down on the beach.
Yeah.
And I can't wait. Now we're talking about it. I'm getting more excited. But, boy, that did bring back all those memories of traveling and big old parties and staying in a big old house with all of us together. And we had a good time. And hot and didn't even know it.
Don't forget the pecan logs.
Oh, I know it. By the way, I got my tickets the other day for the roast.
Oh, good.
They are in hand.
Good.
Looking forward to that.
Hope everybody else is following suit.
Well, I asked, I saw Delight and Afternoon Delight if they wanted to go with us, and they're going to be out of town. So
well,
I guess me and Mister will be there.
I look forward to it. You be sweet.
Thanks for talking to me.
Always enjoy. Take care of yourself.
Bye.
Listen, I want to invite all of you to an October the 7th date, 7th through the 20th, when you can join my wife, Diane, and me for two fabulous weeks in Central Europe. Boy, we're going to see places and do things that you want to be involved in all your life. Vienna, Munich, Salzburg, Innsbruck, we're going to be in the Swiss Alps. We're going to ride cable cars, cog rails. We just go see the Black Forest, which is absolutely beautiful. Just going to have a big time. Take a Rhine River cruise. Everything you can pack into this much time, we're going to do it. Now, it's cost $2,999 per person, double. That includes everything. Transportation, excellent hotels, wonderful breakfast, dinner every day. Guides that'll help us get in and out of place. Just going to be the trip of a lifetime, and I sure do want you to be with us. Call and take a look at this brochure and see if this is something you'd like to do. 1-800-826-2266. 1-800-826-2266. A trip of a lifetime, by golly, and I want you on board. You call them. As we talk to a chili for breakfast. Good morning, young lady.
Good morning, Ludlow. How are you doing?
I'm great. How are you doing?
Just fabulous.
Good.
Well, I can remember those trips so clearly. The little family trips. We had two kinds. The kind with my father and without.
Uh-huh.
The kind with my father included my mother and sister. The kind without included my mother, her mother, her father, her sister, and my sister.
Kind of
Can you imagine why they were that way?
Kind of a moving family reunion.
Well, my father couldn't get in the car with all those.
Yeah.
He would just drive him crazy. But but remember when we lived in Nashville?
Chili, are you on a speakerphone?
No, I'm on a walk-around phone.
Was
it? Is it terrible?
Why don't you walk around and find us a good phone and change while we're talking? Go right ahead.
Well, because I'm in the bathtub.
Oh, okay. All right.
But I can call you again if the reception's really bad.
No, that go ahead. We're all right.
Well, do you remember when I grew up in Nashville, and we always went east or south, so in order to go anywhere, we had to go over a mountain. And to go over a mountain was really a tough thing when you knew you were going to get behind some semi, and it took forever. There'd be 18 cars, and every now and then you'd get in a passing lane, and a few would get around, and the rest of you would just sit there, and I'm sure the cars must have overheated like crazy.
Oh, yeah. That was a common problem in those days.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But we'd head out early, and I think we had breakfast before we left, but it would be lunchtime by about 8 o'clock, so we'd stop into a Howard Johnson's and get an ice cream cone. Good way of keeping children quiet.
Yeah, when you leave before daylight, yeah, you can have lunch at 8 o'clock in the morning.
That's right. Well, yeah. But we didn't have lunch. We just had ice cream.
Yeah.
But it set us up.
You take care of yourself. Call us again.
Okay.
Talk
bye-bye.
To you soon. Bye-bye. Carrolton, Georgia, and talk to Jenny. Hi, Jenny.
Hi.
How you doing?
Oh, fine. I'm so glad to talk to you, Ludlow.
Thank you.
We enjoy your program so much.
Oh, bless your heart. I appreciate it.
We really do. And when you started talking about vacations this morning, it just was like snap. And there I was again, a little kid. And the big thing that I remember about family vacations was that it was really families. I mean, it was my grandparents would organize it, my mother, her sister, her brother, all my cousins. You know, we all knew each other. We played with each other every day.
But a reunion.
Yeah, and, well, we were part of each other's lives so much more than families are now.
Yeah.
We were close, lived close, and took our vacations together. We'd go to Florida, of course. That was where we'd go. We'd go to Daytona. And I can remember how I just, it was all expected. I knew them all, and I counted on them all just like you, I would my mother and my grandparents.
Yeah, I've got a cousin, and we're closer than any brothers. You know,
uh-huh.
Because that's the way you were raised.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's exactly the way it was. And then later on, when my grandfather died, he was kind of the central hub of the family. Then everybody started moving out, and our family started experiencing what a lot of other families have experienced. But I can remember we would always, our big stop was a Stuckey's, and we'd get Granddaddy to stop at Stuckey's. But Grandmother was a big woman. She was heavy, and she called her stomach her bread basket, and all of us grandchildren used to love to crawl up on her bread basket. And when we would travel, every so often she'd have to stop, you know, because of her legs, she'd say. So she'd get Granddaddy stopped so she could get out. We were always so thankful for that bread basket got us out at Stuckey's along the way.
Precious memories, how they linger.
I know it.
Jenny,
know
call
it.
Us again, my love.
All right. Bye.
Good to talk to you. 1-800-572-8255. And boy, we're having fun now. Join us. And you're listening to a taped rebroadcast of my show on News Talk Radio, AM 750, WSB 8255. I'm Ludlow Porch, and we're having a big time. We are remembering some childhood vacations, and, we've talked about a bunch of things. So, movie animals, whatever happens to move you along today. Let's talk to Gene, who's been on hold for 10 minutes. Hello, Gene. How you doing?
How you doing?
I'm great.
Listen, I just feel so good because I know that someday I'm going to be traveling through Roberta and Alma and McRae, and I'm going to find all those places that were there when I was a little girl.
Good.
You know, they're going to be the same. They're not going to change. I don't care what you say. And we're going to have to stop on the side of the road and eat bologna and potted meat. That's the only way my daddy would let us go. I don't know what it is to go in a restaurant on those little roads.
Yeah, we packed our lunch in shoe boxes.
Yeah.
And
we were rich. We didn't have shoes. So
and I can remember sausage and biscuits and you know, all the goodnesses, mm-hmm. and the bologna.
It was always that, and we had to stop on the side of the road, but the most favorite place was at the Hawkinsville Bridge.
The Hawkinsville Bridge.
On the Hawkinsville, when you go across the...
Okay.
This was back in the 40s and 50s. There was a long bridge there. It was long to me then, because I was so little.
Yeah.
But you cross the bridge, and right across the bridge, we'd pull off on the side there at the little river, some little river that ran through there. That was the most beautiful place in the world.
Yeah, and that was your picnic area?
A big tree in Waycross. We had to walk through the woods to the world's largest tree or whatever. But I want to tell you about my favorite movie animal.
All right.
Petey. Petey and the Iron Gang Comedy.
Oh, one of the more famous, too.
When I was a little girl, I thought he was wonderful because he could make smoke come out of his ears.
Yeah.
One time when he got into some hot pepper or something, his eyes just rolled around and smoke came out of his ears, and I thought, this dog is wonderful.
Do anything.
He could turn his head around when he got, you know, and he'd see the gang, and his ears would perk up, and they just loved him, and he loved them, and they would fight for him to the death.
Yeah, he was... Plus, he was smarter than some of those kids, too.
Oh, absolutely. But I never really knew who he belonged to. Never.
Yeah, I don't think it ever said, did it?
I don't ever remember.
Don't think it ever said.
But thanks for talking, Lottie. It was just wonderful hearing all these good stories.
Jane, you be good. I'll talk to you.
Okay, bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. Here is Quick Henry. Hello, Henry.
Hello there. Hey. Well, you're talking about all this vacations, but... We were not bourgeois swine. We were heroes of the proletariat. We didn't have no car till I was 17.
All right.
What did we do? Most of my memory was getting on the Greyhound and trying to control my bodily functions until I got to the Peggy Ann bus stop in Cartersville.
Easier said than done.
Yeah. But let me tell you a cute one about a little guy, me, in Florida. One time my mother and one of her office friends decided to take a vacation in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where Daddy was. He was off in the war somewhere. But we got on the choo-choo and we went down to Jacksonville Beach. And I guess I was probably pretty much ruined that vacation for everybody because I was just being a little kid, see, and they were trying to relax.
Yeah.
But
they should have known better than to take you anyway. Henry.
Right. On the way out of town, this is one of my earliest memories. I have a few earlier, but this is the first really detailed memory I got of this particular incident. On the way out of town, we're standing in a little kiosk waiting for the bus to come. I don't understand a lot about this, but I remember the next door was a house, and I know now the guy was painting his house white, and he was painting the shutters green. And he had gone to take a break or something. But I went over there, and it was obvious this man was going to paint his house green, and I was going to help him. And I had about 30 feet of board painted green before she found me. She got on the bus and went home in a hurry.
Oh, that's funny.
I was about 4 years old, years old, something
but
like
the
that.
Guy who owned the house didn't...
He didn't catch us at it. She got away scot-free.
I love it. A quick mama. We should all have been born with quick mamas.
Can you just imagine him coming out and finding that green stripe down his house?
Yeah, well, you know what? He went next door and jumped on the lady because she had the little hellion anyway.
Yeah, well, the thing is, now that I'm grown, I know that I really didn't do that much damage. A couple of coats of that white paint and straightened that green out in a hurry.
And try to tell that to the guy that's got to put on those two coats of white paint.
No, I understand. But you understand, I could just barely reach the boards. It was just a stripe down one side.
Funny.
He might have kept it. And that made his house look better.
Made you a good memory anyway, didn't it?
Sure did.
I love it. Henry, take care of yourself.
Right.
Talk to you soon.
Right. We'll see you
bye-bye.
Later. Bye-bye.
1-800-572-8255. Ludlow Porch. Listen, I want to tell you folks at Brick Homes out there, You're the ones that think you don't need any siding? Remember last year when you stayed home for the first week of your vacation and painted overhangs and eaves? Didn't have to do that. Now, you ought to call my friends at Taylor Construction Company. That way you can forget about having painters a part of your life. Staying for dinner, messing up your weekend, leaving ladders in the middle of the living room. The whole thing. Listen, you can have Taylor Construction Company put vinyl siding on your eaves, overhangs, and gables. Also install gutters, downspouts. You really owe it to yourself to call these folks and get a free, no-obligation estimate. Listen, a free, no-obligation estimate. Now, once you've done this, you have gone a long way to make sure you get 2 weeks vacation every year and that you don't have to worry about ever painting again. Now, I may not have mentioned this, but I should tell you that Taylor Construction Company also specializes in roofing, insulation replacement, windows. Incidentally, the vinyl windows, out of this world. You need those. And, of course, the vinyl siding. Excellent. Excellent financing available. And for the next 30 callers, write this down, next 30 callers that call for a free estimate, you'll be eligible to receive your choice of a free wireless whole house security system or free insulation in your attic with a completed job. Do this now. You give these folks a call. Got a brick home anywhere in the southeast, you can do business with these folks. Here in the Atlanta area, 491-8761. 491-8761. I'll catch that in a minute. Taylor Construction Company.
This might be the key inning for Sutton. Now Don thinking it over. 3-0, wind up and the pitch. Strike.
Hi, this is Don Sutton. During my 23 years as a major league pitcher, I never wanted the other team to score. But now as honorary chairman of Beer Drinkers of America, I want everyone to get home safely. If your summertime fun involves alcohol, Beer Drinkers of America reminds you, make a game plan first. Party smart. Designate a non-drinking driver before you hit the road. Someone who will drive everyone home safely. And never, ever get behind the wheel of a car if you've had too much to drink. Give the keys to a buddy. And step up to the plate for your friends, too. If they've had too much to drink, don't let them drive either. So don't strike out this summer. Play fair, party smart, and designate a driver. This time, I want you to make it all the way home.
The show you're listening to was taped earlier. Please do not call the numbers that you hear being given out. Now, more conversation on News Talk Radio AM 750, WSB. I got to tell you this. Phone rings. It's not supposed to ring because nobody has his number. You know what the clown said when I answered the phone? Could I speak to the man of the house? You dirt. 1-800-572-8255. Right back to the phone and talk to Cecil. Hello, Cecil.
Hey, Ludlow, how you doing?
Cecil, I'm delighted to have you, and that you don't pronounce your name Cecil.
Well, not me.
No.
No, they do that up north.
All right, buddy.
Any particular reason you put me on right after the Beer Drinkers of America commercial?
None that I can think of.
Very appropriate, anyhow. Well, listen, we used to make a vacation kind of a family affair, like a reunion.
Yeah.
And we'd have my dad's brother and sister and his mother and dad and just all of us go down to Jacksonville.
You know why you did that, don't you?
It's the only way we could afford it.
You couldn't afford a vacation and a reunion.
That's right. That's right. But you heard the saying, you're going to nickel and dime me to death.
Yeah.
I think me and my cousin caused that to come into existence.
You invented it.
We hit on all our aunts, uncles, parents, grandparents, to the point that they didn't have any money. But we used to go through Albany, which is where my parents, or grandparents rather, lived.
Uh-huh.
And we'd stop at a place called the Halfway House on the way there. And it was a place halfway between here and Albany. I don't even know what town it's in, but we always looked forward to getting there and getting us a burger. So uh-huh. We didn't take our lunch. But on the way, there were always stories at certain parts of that trip my daddy would tell. For instance, when we got to Cecil, Georgia, he'd tell how that was named after him. We'd get to Adel, it was so close to hell you could see sparks, and all the little stories, and so you got at a certain point in the trip, and you waited for this story that you'd heard 100 times, but if he didn't tell it, you'd remind him, hey, what about the story?
Because the trip was not complete without the story.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Listen, did you ever play the game Between Two Sheets?
Yeah, Between These Sheets, we called it.
Well, we said Between Two, but same game where you saw a Prince Albert commercial, and you'd say Prince Albert Between Two Sheets.
Yeah.
Every now and then, some pretty funny things would come out of that.
Oh, yeah. Or at least dirty.
Yeah, really. Yeah, now and then, Mom get mad at
which
you.
Which what you were hoping for in the first place, right?
Yeah, that's true. That's true as a kid. And, of course, we always looked forward to the Burma Shave signs and knew about where they were going to be.
Oh, yeah. You soon remembered those.
Yeah.
And, you know, they never changed those.
Well, they didn't need to.
Once they had them up, they never changed them.
Didn't need to. At night, of course, you looked forward to the radio. Listen to the programs, but in the day, of course, you had the windows down, so you listened to the music with wind blowing in your face.
And if you're in the back seat, you couldn't hear it.
Oh, that's right. And that's where I was, of course, but I had the best seat because I was an only child back then for the first 13 years of my life, so I could take my nap. I always had my pillow and my blanket.
Stretch right out.
But then when we got at the beach, we always stayed at the house. We never did stay at a hotel or a motel. Didn't know what that was, and just had a good time with amusement rides and things like that. And it was one of the few times we ever ate seafood. We just didn't go to the store and buy a lot of seafood.
Well, the store didn't have a lot of it.
That's right. So when we were down there, we got some treats as far as I was concerned. And we got sunburned during the day and watched fireworks at night there on the beach. Ate all those corn dogs and candied apples and cotton candy, things you couldn't normally do. That's where that nickel and dime to me to death came from. But we stopped at Stuckey's and B. Lloyd's, and they don't make pecan rolls like they used to, I guarantee.
Cecil, take care of yourself.
All right, laddie. Thanks for the memory.
Talk to you, buddy. Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. Here she is, Pretty Perky Patty. Patty, how you doing?
Hi, I'm doing great.
Good.
This is a great topic. We just had circuses when we went on vacation.
And yeah, y'all, your mom and daddy had 38, 39 children.
Well, I don't think that we need to exaggerate quite that much, but it seemed that way when you
were in the car. How many brothers and sisters do you have?
I have 7.
So there are 8 of you?
There were 8 of us in the car,
and
I was the second oldest, and so, of course, you were responsible for some younger kids, you know, and keeping them in line. So, you know, we sort of had striking privileges on trips, you know. You know, knock it off or I'm going to belt you one. But
He's looking at me, Mama.
Anyway, but we took, we were, you know, we didn't have a lot of money. My dad paid.
Oh, come on. Your old man's a general.
No,
don't give me this.
No, he wasn't a general when we were going
on you took a trip with the canvas top, and you had 2 sergeants driving,
man,
you know.
I wish.
And sea rations.
You think that we ate sea rations. We thought that was, you know, high cotton.
Yeah.
Oh, boy, sea rations
for
dinner. Yeah, we ate those babies.
You remember the little chocolate thing in there shaped like a hockey puck?
Uh-huh. We loved it. I mean, if you got a chocolate thing in your...
but it was so old, Patty, that when you bit into it, it disintegrated.
It turned into dust.
Yeah. Awful. And 4 Camel cigarettes.
Oh, yeah, and they always had a wash and dry in it and all... But that...
And 4 sheets of toilet paper.
Yep, yep. You see, other people didn't know this kind of stuff. We really lived this way. And we went camping. That was our trip. My father never took leave except during the summer. And he would take a month of leave. And we just took these magnificent camping trips, like,
coming from a big family does that for one thing for you. After traveling with 7 brothers and sisters, you never want to see them again.
Well, yeah, yeah.
And you spend the rest of your life trying to forget their names and avoid them.
We really did have a lot of fun. It's funny, we look back on those times with a great deal of fondness, and we've all written about them in various ways.
Yeah.
You know? But no, we had great vacations. I wouldn't have wanted to trade those, but it was a circus. And we always left in the middle of the night. I mean, it was like we were sneaking out of town.
Yeah.
We always had about 3 coolers in our car because, you know, one wasn't going to be enough.
You had 10 people. What kind of car did you have?
We had a very, very big van made by Chevrolet. And I mean, I think it was the biggest van you could possibly have. It had a ton of seats in it. And we still were squinched.
Yeah.
I mean, we just couldn't fit everything in there. And we pulled a pop-up camper. My parents got to sleep in a pop-up camper with the two youngest kids. The rest of us had to sleep in the tent or out under the stars.
They were hoping that some kind of creature would come in the night and trick. Yeah. You would have been back home before anybody missed you.
Well, that's true. And that was always one of my biggest fears, was that somehow on the way to the potty house in the campground, you know, we were going to be snatched by something, a large mosquito perhaps.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
Boy, we just took the most awesome camping trips. And I know people go, oh, camping, yeah, right, you really loved it. We did. We'd sit around that fire and sing, and Dad would tell the best stories.
You know what? But you see, you can enjoy camping until you find out about room service.
Well, I like going, you know, on really nice trips and resorts and all that, and we've gone to some very nice places, but I love to camp. I really
enjoy last time
it.
The last time I camped,
uh-huh,
a very unpleasant man with sergeant stripes made me sleep in a hole that I had only recently dug. And I promised the Lord that night, if he'd get me out of that hole, I would never sleep outdoors again.
As God is your witness.
He did, yeah. And I haven't.
Well, bravo. But
camping ain't normal.
Oh.
Therefore, normal people don't camp.
Well, my kids have never...
A mouth breather named Fred may camp. People whose daddies are generals don't camp.
Oh, yes, they do.
Simply isn't done.
Well, he wasn't a general then. He was a lowly major.
Oh, poor baby.
Oh.
Poor baby. Growing up in a deprived household.
Well, I'll tell you, the trips we took in Europe, I wish I had time to tell you about those.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what, we'll put a time aside another time.
But bravo.
Sounds like great fun, camping and all. But just think how much better been had you been indoors. Take care of your sweet self.
You are so mean.
You know I love you, Patty.
Uh-huh.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
1-800-572-8255 is our number. Listen, I don't want to nag you about this, but you need to do this. Remember last year, one morning we were talking, and I told you that the pollen index was five times as bad as usual. Now, I know that's... Right back to the phones as we talk to Ed. Edward, how are you?
Good morning. How you doing?
I'm great, partner. I hope you are.
I think somebody's already mentioned the Burma Shave signs, but I always enjoyed seeing those. I wish I could remember all of them, the sayings they had on them.
Well,
Tony presents Tom and Ham on Breakfast.
What in the world is that?
Breakfast, doofus.
A biscuit ain't breakfast.
Hey, it's fast food, okay?
That's not fast food. That's a fast biscuit. Now, fast food would be eggs, bacon, grits, hash browns, fresh fruit, and coffee at Shoney's Breakfast Bar.
I was in a hurry.
So what'd you do? Sit in a drive-thru line for 10 minutes?
Cyril Greenberg. You want to know what an ex-mortician does for a living? Listen to the Ludlow Porch Show every day and you'll see. Join in on the fun. Call 1-800-572-TALK. That's 1-800-572-8255. Here's Porchy.
Well, good morning, fun seekers. How y'all? And welcome to the new folks along the network that are joining us. A little late today. We are glad to have you with us, and we're talking about a bunch of things. We kind of zeroed in, I guess, on childhood vacations and how much they've changed and how you don't spend as much time looking for a Stuckey's as a B. Lloyd's since they put in expressways, and you don't have to leave as early now that you have air conditioning in your car. You know what I think? I think that was a ploy. I think the mamas and daddies wanted to leave early because children would sleep along the way. You can't blame them for that. Talked to a bunch of folks, had a bunch of great memories, and we want to talk to you. 1-800-572-8255. And here she is. Peanut is with us. Good morning, sweet Peanut.
Good morning, sweet thing. How are you
How
doing,
you doing
this morning?
You know who just walked in here?
Who?
All the way from Cartersville, Georgia.
Who?
Pony and her...
Pony?
And her... Large, attractive son, Nathan, are here.
Bless their sweet heart.
You know what that means, don't you?
What's that?
Ain't nobody in Cartersville getting any mail today.
That's true. Let's don't tell them. Let's be
not
a surprise.
Not a word.
Can I deviate from the subject just a minute?
Yeah,
you know, I had to call in. I heard my name taken in vain while ago.
Is that the funniest thing you ever heard?
That is hilarious. The House Peanut Subcommittee?
Right.
My Lord. You know, they got their nerve. They used my name, and they didn't ask my permission.
That's funny.
I think I ought to get some compensation out of that somewhere down the line. I'm talking about going to Florida. Man, oh, man, I am not a good traveler. Never have been.
Not a good traveler?
Not a good traveler. Get car sick. Oh.
Do you really?
Long way to Florida.
Yeah.
Oh, and then we'll forget 1 year. We had a date the night before we left and went to the cotton patch. I don't know if you remember the cotton patch or not.
I do remember the cotton patch.
From the varsity.
I was a small boy, but I remember hearing about it.
Right, right. And we got a hamburger and a grape drink. I have never had another grape drink in my life. And we started at about 3 or 3:38 and going down there. My poor mother had to stop about every mile or so for me to get out and not chuck. Got down there, and this was before everything was air conditioned. Hotel room was like an oven. They didn't even have the window open. So I told her, I said, I think I'm getting
And it wasn't air conditioned either, was it?
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right. That was before the air conditioning, you know. And I told her, I said, well, I think I will take a bath, and maybe that'll make me feel a little bit better. So I went in there, got my bath, stood up to get out of the tub, and fainted dead away like a rock on the bathroom floor.
Mm.
Scared the tar out of her. I will never forget that trip. Never forget that trip. But I always loved Florida, but it was going back and forth that got me then. And because I was in the back seat, come to find out, after I started driving, I've never been car sick again.
I'll be darned.
And bad it was part being about in the back seat.
Yeah, the bad part about the Florida trip was after you got there, wherever you stayed was just as hot as the car.
Yeah, right. Not the truth.
Awful, awful.
Awful, awful.
But it did, you know, the human mind is a great thing because we wipe out.
That's right.
Completely all the nights that we couldn't sleep at all in Florida because it was so hot.
That's right. And sweat just pouring off of you.
And the flea bag motels that you stayed in, you know.
Oh, that's the truth.
All that gets wiped out. And all we remember is the laughter and how a corn dog tastes and how much fun it is to swim in the ocean. We forget how it is to be sticky with salt water and have sand down your trunks.
As a little girl. As a small, very small child coming up, I had a lot of sinus problems, a lot of sinus infections. And the doctor told my daddy to take me to the beach and keep ducking my head in the water, that salt water. And do you know that cleared it up?
Really?
Really. That cleared it up.
I would have thought that killed you.
I thought it did at the time.
Yeah.
Almost drowned me, but it cured me. But, you know, that's just a real simple thing. If somebody's got sinus trouble, go to Florida.
Precious memories.
Yes, indeed. And I just want to say how much I appreciate you and Diane. You're just shining examples of being dumped on, and you didn't stay down. You got up, you dusted yourself off, and you're doing better now. And I just want to say God bless you both. God bless all the wackos.
You take care.
If it wasn't for you making us laugh when nothing's funny in our lives, then I just don't know what we'd do with action. I just want to say thank you this morning.
God love you. Take care of yourself.
Love you too, hon.
Talk to you soon. Bye-bye. More conversation right after this.
In the kitchen, in the bathroom, on your desk, in the hallway, in the living room.
There are lots of places in your house you could use a free light bulb. So stop by any Georgia Power office and pick up a free energy-efficient Philips light bulb now while supplies last. It's in support of National Night Out, America's Night Out Against Crime. And while you're there, ask Georgia Power where you could use outdoor security lighting, like
over the garage, by the alley, in the backyard.
After 6 years, 4 months, and 17 days in prison, I am free.
Surely there is nothing so sweet, so beautiful, so precious as freedom and liberty.
For over 30 years, Amnesty International has worked to free prisoners of conscience, to stop torture, to prevent executions, and to protect human rights. Amnesty International. Raise your voice. 1-800-55-AMNESTY.
This is Richie Havens for the American Red Cross.
Let's join our hands and join our hearts. Ooh, make a harmony out of all the parts. We're striking a chord, together moving toward a dream.
Different parts to play in the American Red Cross. Call your local chapter and play your part. I'm Richie Havens, saying thanks.
Now is the time. Now is the time.
The show you're listening to was taped earlier. Please do not call the numbers that you hear being given out. Now, more conversation on News Talk Radio AM 750, WSB. 1-800-572-8255 as we move to the other doctor. Good morning, your doctorship.
Good morning, good morning.
How you doing?
Car in ditch, driver in tree. Moon was full, so was he. Bermashade.
My favorite, what you shouted may be true, but did you hear what he called you?
Right. And do we take 31E or 31W heading south from Louisville?
That's right.
That was one of the big debates.
That's right. You want to be able to cut off the traffic whenever you can.
That's right. Out on the road at 4 a.m.
And your daddy knew which road the trucks took, and he wanted to take the other one.
Oh, yeah. But somehow or other, they changed their mind.
Yeah.
Mammoth Cave, Horse Cave, and Cave. Hey, we only been on the road an hour.
Yeah.
Or it was an hour from home.
They had some of those up at Cherokee.
Mm-hmm.
One of the most disappointing times of my life. They had some of those at Cherokee. And finally, I talked my grandmother and grandfather into stopping there. As a grandchild, you've got much more leverage than you do as a child.
Oh, yeah.
And we went in there, and when you walked through the teepee door, it was a regular hotel room.
Yeah. Same thing with these.
I wanted skins on the wall. and a fire in the middle of the floor.
Yeah.
But no.
Some old girl over there cooking up dog meat or something.
Exactly. Well, whatever, yeah.
Yeah, sharpening spears.
Yeah.
There was a house on 31E somewhere between, right around the border between Kentucky and Tennessee. And you come up over the hill. Of course, two-lane road. And none of these long grades. It's up and down and around.
Yeah.
Come up over the hill, and then suddenly sharp drop down. And there's this house right at the turn. Couldn't have been 5 feet off the highway.
Mm.
And every time we went down to Florida, my father would get, we'd get close to that place and say, wonder if that place is still there. Wonder if somebody hasn't sent it off into the ravine. It was always there. Nobody hit it.
That's funny. Yeah, but those are landmarks. And you know, I used to always know when we were getting close to any one thing by the landmark.
Yeah, yeah.
When I would see the first, I knew we were getting close to Okie Vanokie when I would see the first Green Frog Hotel and Gift Shop sign.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
And I knew I was getting close to my aunt's house, time to stop, because she lived in Atlanta. She lived in southwest Atlanta. I get into this big old city and see this big old Coca-Cola sign. Hey, we're almost to Aunt Helen's.
Yeah.
Oh, one of your other topics?
Yeah.
Favorite movie animal.
Favorite movie animal.
Well, he's about 6 feet tall, and he's a puka.
Yeah, yeah.
Harvey is his name.
I've got that movie. When I can't stand it any longer, I take it out and read a great all-time movie.
Oh, yeah. That's one of the kinds of things that just cleans out all the cobwebs, gets rid of all the politicians and all the tinsel.
I think I've told you before, one of my prized possessions is a thing that Diane bought for me. It's in a large frame, and half of it is an autographed picture of Jimmy Stewart holding a stuffed rabbit in his Harvey regalia, and beside that is an 8x10 or a 10x10 caricature that Jimmy Stewart drew of Harvey. And it's right at the end of a hall in our house, and I see it every day. It's wonderful. I'm going to be buried with it if I ever decide to die.
Ah, well, you know. Okay.
You know what, George Burns? You want to hear something? I had this great weekend planned. My tomatoes are going to be ripe this weekend. I've been waiting since I was a teenager for these tomatoes to be ripe. And my agent called me last night. Got a speech in Beaumont, Texas, Saturday. Asked me if I can get to the North Georgia Mountains and Beaumont, Texas on the weekend. The answer is no.
What's in Beaumont, Texas?
Mobile oil and a check with my name on it. I'm going to see them both.
Well, so much for tomatoes. I'll bring you some tomatoes. Go on to Texas. I'll bring you some tomatoes.
You take care of your bad self.
Sure, you do.
I'll talk to you about it. The other doctor. Listen, want you to join my wife, Diane, and me on a spectacular fall tour, Germany, Austria, Switzerland. You know where we're going. But you don't know how much we're going to laugh. We're going to have a big time. We're going to travel through the Black Forest, the Swiss Alps, relax on a Rhine River cruise. Just going to be a great 2 weeks. Vienna, Munich, every place you've heard about and want to visit. Now, for your free brochure, I want you to do this. I want you to call the folks that have the brochures, 1-800, it wouldn't make any sense to call anybody else. I mean, you know, you call Fred Johnson, he ain't got no brochures. 1-800-826-2266. 1-800-826-2266. And tell them you want to check out the possibility of going to Central Europe with Ludlow Porch. And we'll see you on October the 7th. And you might want to start buying extra sweaters now because it's going to be cool in Europe. 1-800-572-8255. We'd like to have you join us.
Atlanta's Morning News. Dependable information updated regularly from AM 750 WSB reporters in the city and the suburbs. Plus, every 6 minutes, hear weather and traffic. Atlanta's Morning News on AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
At Georgia Good.
Georgia Girl's fall preview is very you with your kind of hot items, your kind of prices. We're very you at the office with related separates. Jackets just $22.99. Pants and skirts only $16.99 in 4 great fall colors. And many of our fall dresses are very you at under $40. You'll find dozens of other hot items at your prices too, including suede and silk. Suede shorts in hot colors, $32.99. Long sleeve dye to match silk shirts only $22.99. A hot outfit for anywhere. And we're very you with colored denim jeans for just $22.99 in 6 sensational colors. With fall's best shirts and vests to match at your prices, too. Check it any day. Say it anyway. Georgia Girl's fall preview is very you.
The look that you want is the look that you find. At Georgia Girl, we're very you.
The fun is fixing to start 4 o'clock this afternoon for Sandy Garfield, Larry Munson, Gary McKee and the gang, and the Hometown Radio Show. Now more on Atlanta's News, Weather, and Traffic Station, the Big News Talk Radio, AM 750 WSB.
Hi, I'm Ludlow Porch, and you're listening to a taped rebroadcast of my show on News Talk Radio, AM 750 WSB. Family vacation. Let's leave at 3 o'clock in the morning. We got to get there. I never quite understood that. Still don't understand. People do that still. Got to get there. Why? If you leave at a decent hour and stop along the way for breakfast, then you have made that first day out part of the vacation, an enjoyable thing. You have not created a hell on earth for your wife and family. And some wives are guilty of it, too. 1-800-572-8255. Polly is with us. Good morning, Polly.
Good morning.
How you doing?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
Doing great.
I just love your show, and I just love to hear them people talk about their vacations.
Good.
So, what I remember is my vacation when I was a child. We lived in Dalton, Georgia, out on a farm. We have later crops by in the summertime, you know, we got to lay them by when we got to plow them.
Right.
Yes. We'd fix, or my father and the cousins and uncles would fix three or four covered wagons. And we'd go across the LJ, across the LJ Mountains, and way on up the Blue Ridge, to Blue Ridge, and over to Cherry Log, from my granddaddy lived, both granddaddies.
And you're in a wagon, Polly?
In a wagon, in a covered wagon with a, we called it a rainbow of the wagon.
About what year was that, Polly?
31, 32, and 33.
All right.
And we'd enjoy it so much, we'd stop. It would take us 2 days to get there. We'd stop and, of course, let the mules rest and get out and walk and have a good time.
Yeah. I was in Cherry Log the other day.
You was?
Yeah.
But I lived up above Cherry Log.
All right. Well, Cherry Log's still Cherry Log.
Yeah, have you ever been through Snake Nation?
Through what?
Snake Nation.
If I did, I didn't know where I was.
A lot of people never heard of Snake Nation. It's halfway between Warrington and Blue Ridge.
Well, then I've been through it, because I've been all up there.
That's where we have the Stanley decoration. I was Stanley before marriage, and we had a Stanley decoration up there every third Sunday in August.
Yes, sir. I'm glad you called, Polly.
Okay, you have a good day.
All right, my friend.
Enjoy your show.
Thank you very much. Joe in Rome. Hello, Joe.
Hello.
Hello, Joe.
Rip a fender off your car. Send it in for a half-pound jar. Burma shade.
I love it.
That's one of the best ones.
They have
about the roast. When is it? How you get tickets?
Well, it's August 4th. Joe, I'm so glad you called. Joe, it's August the 14th, Joe.
Okay.
And we had decided that if you didn't call by today, we were going to cancel it.
Uh-huh.
So our fate is in your hands. Joe, you can you need to call area code 404-636-9237.
All right.
Or jump on your motorcycle and go to the Knights of Columbus, 2620 Buford Highway, Northeast Atlanta.
2620.
Yeah. It's the 14th. We're going to have barbecue. You're going to hear some of the funniest people on this earth just tear the flesh off my back. And then you get to hear me tear back. Denny's going to be there.
Oh.
My more than large producer, the other doctor, Rendezvous, is going to be there. And I know you can't wait to see Rendezvous.
Oh, no.
The Georgia Bulldog, the world's foremost dog fan, is going to be there. Kitty Litter, Lofty A-Frame Pony, coming all the way from Cartersville. Sheriff Milton Crabapple with his 12. The whole gang's going to be there, Joe. And if you don't come, we're coming after you.
Wonderful. And how do I get tickets?
Call 614.
Oh, call this number.
636-9237.
They'll tell me all about it.
They'll either tell you that, or they'll meet you on the side of the road with a handful of tickets, or they'll run by your house. Whatever it takes to get your fine self there, we'll do it.
Wonderful. Thank you.
All right, Joe, listen, I want you to come up and tell me who you are now.
All right, will do.
Talk to you, buddy.
Good.
1-800-572-8255 to Brunswick and my buddy Sam. Hello, Sam.
Hello, am I on?
How you doing? You're all over the radio, Sam.
Oh.
Only seconds away from becoming a folk hero.
Should I get nervous about it?
I would.
Uh-oh, well, let me shake here for a second. Yeah, that enough?
You got it now, Sam.
I was
Can you imagine somebody just tuning this in? They're going to be convinced that one of us is nuts, and I hope it's you, Sam.
Well, maybe both of us are a little bit nuts. Anyway, I was listening to the show this morning.
Yeah.
On the subject of family vacation. I grew up in the northwest Georgia mountains up in Walker County.
Yeah.
And my family decided we were going to go to Panama, Destin Beach, which is just a little ways out of Panama City.
Mm-hmm.
And we loaded up in the family car. It was me and my brother, my parents, and this was like 64, and I think I was 12, just starting to notice the girls were a little different from guys.
Mm-hmm. Softer.
And getting interested. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we were, of course, we didn't have any air conditioning. And my father was one of these kind of people. He likes to get there.
Mm-hmm.
So he didn't drive terribly slow. And I remember going down there wasn't too bad because we were excited about going to the beach and going to the ocean. But coming back, I don't think we got on the road before about 7 or 8 o'clock.
He let you sleep in till 7.
Yeah. Well, I sleep in till 6.
Yeah.
Then we had to get to the car loaded up. But I remember on the way back, I was just tall enough that with all the windows rolled down on the car and rolling down the highway about 60 or 65, all of that wind that was coming through the front windows, of course, me and my brother were in the back seat, hit me square in the head. And it was like sitting, it was probably 90, 95, 100 degrees. It was like sitting in a hot hurricane.
Sam, hold the thought. I'll be right back. It's that damn guitar player again. Don't go away, Sam. I'll be right back. 1-800-572-8255. Stay with us, gang.
All right.
Miss a thing. Keep it set on AM 750 WSB and check in 2, 3, 4 times a day. You can depend on AM 750 WSB to bring you breaking news quickly and thoroughly. Atlanta's news, weather, and traffic station, AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
Hi, I'm Richard Dumas, owner of J&R Clothing, with locations on Georgia Highway 85 in Riverdale and Georgia Highway 85 in North Fayette County. J&R Clothing is a family-owned clothing store in business since 1968. We have a very simple policy for success. Sell name brand quality clothes for the entire family. Sell at discount prices. Savings of 25 to 30% every day. Give you the personal service you deserve. Do alterations in our store for free. J&R Clothing has most everything you and your family wear. We have Hager suits on sale from $89 to $145. Sewell and Lacrosse year-round and 100% worsted suits on sale from $159 to $199. Sizes up to 60 extra long. Sansibelt suits on sale from $199. Perry Ellis suits on sale from $249. We can fit most every body and every pocketbook. J&R Clothing, Georgia Highway 85 in Riverdale and North Fayette County.
My wife used to drink or take pills whenever anything went wrong. Even little things like a bad day at work would be an excuse for a binge.
But when I found help at Charter, I learned why those things got me so upset. I mean, everyone has bad days, but there are better ways to handle them.
Our whole family, even the kids, was affected, and nothing seemed to help her. We all tried, but we didn't understand what the problem was until we called Charter.
It is possible to live without alcohol or drugs. At Charter, the whole family learns to cope with the process of recovery. Then, recovery continues at home, one day at a time.
I still have bad days, days when I'd like a drink. My life is in control again. I don't want to give that up.
She's doing great. We all are.
Call Charter Winds Hospital in Athens today, 1-800-542-4464. That's 1-800-542-4464.
The Black Wave and the Red Gun with Nonstop Falcons Fun. Stay tuned to News Talk Radio, AM 750 WSB. The wars begin in just a few more days. Kickoff countdown, 4.
Hi, Fun Seekers. Ludlow Porch. Hey, I hope you're enjoying this broadcast of one of my earlier programs. Remember, you can hear my show live weekdays at 9 a.m. Right now, let's get a check on the weather forecast.
The WSB 5-day forecast for the overnight, partly cloudy, isolated showers ending. Low 69. Tomorrow, lots of clouds with a 50% chance of a shower. High 83, low 70. The extended outlook Thursday through Saturday, partly cloudy with a thundershower possible. Thursday and Friday, highs 85, low 67. Recapping the overnight weather, partly cloudy, isolated showers ending. Low 69. Right now, it's 72.
Porch, and you're listening to a taped rebroadcast of my show on News Talk Radio, AM 750, WSB. 1-800-572-8255. Back to Sam in Brunswick. Sam,
Yes.
Last time we were together, you were telling us about sitting in a...
The back seat of a...
100-degree hurricane.
100-degree hurricane. I don't think I've ever been so miserable on the road in my life.
Yeah.
That was terrible. I kept complaining about it. And finally, my mother decided, well, I'll swap places with him for a little while. It wasn't 10 minutes. She came back up in the front seat and said, looked at my father and said, I can't handle this. He's going to have to get back in the back. And he looked at her. She looked like a haystack with her hair all blown all over the place. A couple other things happened on that vacation. My brother and I, I'm 8 years older than him, we were walking past a motel swimming pool, and I noticed one especially cute blonde girl. And I looked at him. I said, hey, she's really cute. So, of course, he cuts loose with, I mean, real loud wolf whistle, you know. And she looked over in our direction and gave me a look that would kill. And we got back in the motel room, and I gave him a look that would have killed. My mother was wondering what was going on, and I told her, and she thought it was terribly funny, and I didn't see the humor in it. But I kind of got a last laugh at him, because a night or two later, we were out catching crabs and crab nets, little tiny nets. Well, he caught one, and he reached down that night to grab that crab. The crab grabbed him first, and he let out a howl that you'd hear halfway around the world. So I kind of got even with my little brother on that trip.
I love it.
It was a pretty good trip, though, even though he embarrassed me at the swimming pool and that crab grabbed him first, and we got blown away from home.
Little brothers normally embarrass you until you're well into your 30s.
Well, I'm almost 40, and I don't know if you... We don't hang together an awful lot. We live far enough apart that I don't know if he's, embarrasses me that bad or not. Maybe I'm getting back at him. I'm embarrassing him now.
Take a vacation with him sometime. You'll find out. Sam, take care of yourself.
Okay.
I'll talk to you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Kitty Litter on board. Hello, Mrs. Litter.
Well, good morning, Luddy.
How you doing?
Well, I'm doing pretty good.
Good.
I happen to know that you have your own personal Burma Shave sign.
That's true.
Yes.
That's true. I see it almost every day.
Uh-huh. Well, the one I remember the most is, from way back when I was, just a little thing. She kissed her husband by mistake. She thought it was her husband, Jake. And that tickled me when I was 5 or 6 years old. That was between LaBelle and Fort Myers.
All right.
Yes, and that was a long, hot trip between LaBelle and Fort Myers.
One of the all-time great advertising gimmicks.
It really and truly was. Well, I've been working on the roast, Ludlow. And let me tell you, this is not just going to be a roast. It's going to be a total expose.
I love it.
And I just wish that Ted Koppel was going to be there.
He'll be there in spirit.
Because it'll make all the headlines. It really, and I'd like for him to be the first with it.
Let me give you a little warning.
Yes.
If I may.
Okay.
I was at the Blue Ribbon yesterday.
Uh-huh.
With Paul.
Yeah.
Paul Cicchetti, the famous fighting dwarf.
Oh, yeah.
And he's going to be our master of ceremonies. We've already ordered the... egg crate for him to stand on. But he was showing particular interest in your name.
Well,
that list. So be ready. Be ready.
Well, I had lunch over there the other day and talked to Paul.
Yeah.
And so anyhow, I told him, you're really going to get it.
Be ready.
And he said, good. And I'll be ready, yes. I'm always ready, Luddy. You know that.
I know that. I know that. You can do a roast with a drop of a hat.
Well, I don't normally do that sort of thing. But anyhow, I'm in a better mood because I have got two lawyers to take care of this mess down in Florida involving two judges, a lawyer, a funeral home, and a real estate company.
Get after them, Kitty. Sound like two lawyers may not be enough.
Well, you're right. They might not, but we'll see.
A lot of suing needs to be done now.
Oh, gee. Yeah, something. But anyhow, I'm really looking forward to this, and I think that this will probably be the most shocking roast you have ever attended.
I think so, too.
I think so.
I mean, what I have found out about some of y'all is pretty shocking.
Well, I doubt that it will compare with yours, Luddy.
Be a lot of white trash there that night, Kitty.
Well, you just be good and hang in there, hold your breath, and I'm going to bring you something to defend yourself with, though.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Good. You take care. I'll talk to you.
Do it or have it done.
Thank you, dear.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bill on a car phone. Hello, Bill.
Hey, Ludlow.
How you doing, buddy?
Free. A trip to Mars for just 900 empty jars. That was always my favorite. Hey, I was riding up on North Side while I going to heard you talk about the Green Frog. Now I'm from Waycross, because I've been up here for 30 years. But
yeah.
I just wanted to throw something at you there. You might not know the two fellas that started that thing and ran it, Bill and Denham Darden, they're also the ones that started the Red Lobster chain.
Really?
Yeah, and in fact, one of them is still kind of active in it, but they sold out to General Foods or somebody about 10, 15, 20 years ago, but they got it kind of rolling, but they kind of got a little wealthy out of the restaurant business.
The green Frog was a landmark. I mean, it was there, signs in both directions, and if you got by there without knowing what they had, you just wasn't paying attention.
When I grew up, it was just a drive-in restaurant. It had curb service and everything, and then they eventually made it a sit-down type restaurant. But
yeah.
It was actually a curb restaurant at one time. Speaking of Waycross, I hadn't been down there too much. I moved up here in 63, but I went back to my 30th reunion, and all those little girls went to school with, they were short and petite.
Mm-hmm.
They still short.
I hope they don't recognize your voice.
I hope not. But the thing about it, just before I went down there, somebody said, oh, you'll love it. So we went to ours last year, and they went to see all our old teachers in the old schoolhouse. And I said, boy, that's going to be nice. I got down there, they tore the schoolhouse down, and all the teachers were dead.
Yeah, they shouldn't fool around with your childhood, should they?
That's right. One quick thing I'll get off here. Speaking about traveling. My wife was from South Georgia, and her father, he wasn't much one to travel. Any South Georgia farmers, he'd never been to Alabama or South Carolina. Went to Jacksonville one time in his life, but he finally ventured out after about 20 years, decided to come to Atlanta and see us. He came up here, and his first observation, he says, now I know why those wagons I saw come through town years ago had brakes on them. I'll let you
hang in there. I'll talk to you.
All right.
Bye-bye. 1-800-572-8255. More conversation right after this.
In the kitchen, in the bathroom, on your desk, in the hallway, in the living room.
There are lots of places in your house you could use a free light bulb. So stop by any Georgia Power office and pick up a free energy-efficient Philips light bulb now while supplies last. It's in support of National Night Out, America's Night Out Against Crime. And while you're there, ask Georgia Power where you could use outdoor security lighting, like over the garage, by the alley, in the backyard.
Honey, I bought a gift for the baby.
Harold, we don't have a baby.
It's a U.S. savings bond.
Harold, I'm not even pregnant.
I know, but someday we'll have children,
uh-huh.
And it's never too early to start planning for our family.
But Harold, there's so many other things we'll need.
Savings bonds will help us save for our son's future.
Son?
Yeah. Savings bonds can be tax-free for education,
uh-huh.
And the value will more than double by the time Harold Jr. is ready for his first year at Harvard.
Harvard.
Start planning for your child's future. Call 1-800-US-BONDS today.
I'm going to buy another bond.
For what?
Medical school, of course.
Of course.
Hello, I'm Dr. Joyce Brothers. Your smile is one of your most important features, so treat it with special care. Take time to brush and floss every day. That's the only way to remove plaque, the invisible film of bacteria that forms on your teeth and gums. Plaque is the number one cause of tooth decay and gum disease. Just a few minutes a day of good oral care can give you a lifetime of healthy smiles.
Hello, this is Lorenzo Lamas. Here's an interesting fact. If you're an adult, 3 out of every 4 of you listening to this message have periodontal disease, also called gum disease. Gum disease is the leading cause of tooth loss in adults. Beat the odds. Brush and floss every day and get regular professional cleanings. It's the only way to remove the plaque that causes infection. This dental health message is brought to you by your local dental society and the American Dental Association.
Gang. 1-800-572-8255. Talking about a bunch of stuff. Talking about almost anything, matter of fact. And we would like to talk to you. 1-800-572-TALK. Amy is with us. Hello, Miss Amy. How you doing?
I'm fine, Ludlow.
Good.
I think this is some sort of record I got through so quick.
Well, we saw it was you, and our heart absolutely leapt.
Bless your heart. I was thinking the other day about how when my mother would hear about somebody doing something nice, she'd say, well, that's a star in her crown.
Yeah.
So that's a star in your crown.
I hope so.
I was thinking about the vacations we used to take down in Panama City.
Yeah.
And the rooms in the hotel, Lolo, were just a screen sort of thing between your room and the hall. It was one of those doors that was open at the top and the bottom.
A louvered door.
Well, yeah, but...
Used to have a lot of those in George Raft movies.
It didn't go all the way to the floor or to the top of the door.
Oh, really?
Yeah. You know, somebody could have easily crawled under there. It was so hot. Nobody's going to bother anybody. But I think that's amazing. That was back in the late 40s, early 50s.
Yeah.
And there was that. You just opened to the hall.
I don't know what you're talking about. It was about a foot above the door and about a foot below the door.
Yeah, and it had a fabric insert over the louver.
Yeah.
To sort of give you some privacy,
see,
I suppose.
They didn't care if the boogers got you or not.
Well, I guess the boogers just the hot that didn't have any in them.
Boogers
bother anybody.
Boogers were looking for a shady spot in Panama City.
There wasn't even a ceiling fan in that room. You
just
had to leave the door open and leave it up to nature, whether you melted or not. But that's one of my, and that and the seafood. That was, get a combination plate, and you'd have a dozen shrimp, a dozen oysters, seemed like. Just this huge pile of food for less than a dollar.
Yeah.
Yeah, and oh, so good. Right there on the water, the one place I remember was just almost sitting out on pilings out into the water.
That
and served that wonderful shrimp and oysters.
That's before the government told them where they had to build and how they had to build.
Yeah. Well, anyway, we used to
good memories.
Gouge ourselves.
Amy, come see us.
Okay, bye.
Talk to you. Let's talk to Bambi on the radio. Hi, Bambi.
You know, Luddy, I thought that you guys were brought up with hard times like me, but I just found out today you guys were born with a silver spoon in y'all's mouth.
We're a very rich family. We were so rich, we even had middle names.
I'm telling you. You know, now, I'm sure that a bunch of folks from Carrolton, New Hope, Mount Zion, they're going to know what I mean when I say this.
Tell me.
Well, our vacation was at least maybe a mile from where I lived. We went to Buck Creek and had our picnics. And if you hadn't been to Buck Creek, you must go to Buck Creek.
I've always wanted to. Where's Buck Creek?
Buck Creek is between Carrolton and Mount Zion, and it's the best little old swimming hole. Now, I don't know. It may not even be there anymore, but we'd go to our picnics. We couldn't afford to go on trips. My Lord, we had to raise gardens and stuff like that. You know, I thought we were rich. We had turnip greens and stuff like that to eat all the time. But Jesus Christ, you folks was rich compared to what I was. We didn't get to go off for no two or three days. We just take off maybe on a Saturday or Sunday and go down to Buck Creek. Boys would be on one side because they'd have to go in their birthday suit.
Yeah.
Girls would be in the other with their little white panties on.
Well, you see, y'all were going to an orgy. We're going on vacation.
Well, that's true, too. That's true, too. But the only thing about it, though, like I said, lady, we were separated. You know, they had one swimming hole, and we had another little old swimming hole.
Hey, Bambi.
What?
This is Letty you're talking to.
You and Denny's going to let all my secrets out.
Ain't no secret. Everybody said I've been swimming in a washhole in the South and knows that you wasn't telling the truth.
But boy, did we have fun.
Yeah, how far upstream were you?
Oh, well, we saw him playing Tarzan many a time. So.
I got to go, baby. Take care of yourself.
Love you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Yeah, swimming separate. 1-800-572-8255. Matthew is with us. Hello, Matthew.
Hello, Ludlow.
How you doing, pal?
All right. This is the Connecticut Yankee. Last time I talked to Woody Duck.
That's right.
All right.
Good to have you back, Matthew.
I'm a big listener. Listen, You're talking about summer vacations. I was in the car.
Yeah.
And I got to tell you one that we've been going on for 30 years up in Connecticut there. We'd go up to New Hampshire every year and get in the car. But my mother, we had 12 kids in our family.
Ooh.
One year after another. A lot of Irish twins, in fact. But anyway, we can still remember that trip because that was our big trip out of the year, other than going to Grandma's. You know, we get in the car. And there's one guy, Norman Rockwell, I'm sure you know him or heard of him.
Yeah.
Well, he has one picture that I'll always remember. I was thinking about it when you were talking about the vacations. Was the one where it was two parts. And on the top picture was they were going on their vacation, and they were all happy and excited. And, of course, on the bottom, they were coming back from vacation. They were all tired out, and Grandma was sleeping, and the kids, and the father's yelling at the kids. And I just remember that and what you've been talking about.
I don't guess anybody ever captured the feeling, real Americana, like Rockwell.
Rockwell, oh, yeah.
Yeah, just the greatest.
That's
absolutely
it.
Great. Matthew, don't be gone so long.
All right.
Take care of yourself.
All right, Ludlow.
Bye-bye, buddy. 1-800-572-8255. We're talking about your childhood vacations. Wouldn't a vacation in Vermont, New Hampshire, been something? That was up north, where they called little bitty rocks pebbles. Remember that? 1-800-572-8255. Ludlow Porch holding forth on a Tuesday, and we want to hear about some of your memories or about anything else that may be on your mind. Here's what you do. You call 1-800-572-8255. Or 1-800-572-TALK. We'd like to have you join us. Hi, this is Ludlow Porch, and I want to tell you about a dream I had the other night. I dreamed I was back in Miss Gurr's fifth grade history class. Miss Gurr told me to go to the board and write down Patrick Henry's most famous quote. I wrote, "Give me liberty or give me Canette Dairy's milk." She said, "That's right. Now, write down how Columbus kept his sailors from getting scurvy." I wrote down that he gave them Canette lime sherbet. Miss Gurr said, "Very good. Now, tell us why Davy Crockett went to the Alamo." And I said, "He went there to stop the Mexicans from eating all the delicious creamy Canette ice cream that they were serving at the Alamo snack bar." I made 100 in history that day. Now, I know it was only a dream, but I thought it would make a heck of a Canette dairy commercial. Now, hey, if your store doesn't have Canette products, ask them to get it for you, and I need for you to do that no later than 3 o'clock tomorrow. The clock is ticking. Go ask for that good stuff.
There's nothing like a classic movie to bring home all of life's feelings. Like when you lose your heart.
What is it you want, Barry? You want the moon? Just say the word and I'll throw a lasso around it and pull it down.
Flirt shamelessly.
So let's talk about me. Let's talk about you. What kind of man are you?
Or simply roar with laughter.
I could dance with you till the cows come home. On second thought, I'd rather dance with the cows till you come home.
Only one cable channel touches your heart by bringing you continuous classic movies. Uncut, uncolorized, and commercial-free. American Movie Classics. 50 years of Hollywood, from dramas to comedies, westerns to mysteries.
Now you've got it. That's the idea exactly.
See these great movies and more on American Movie Classics. We bring back the feeling.
Call your local Atlanta cable operator or 473-8300 today and get cable installed in your home for just $19.95. You'll save 50% off their regular standard installation rate, but you better hurry. Offer expires August 30th. Certain restrictions apply.
Mr. Hudson?
Jerry!
Larry, are you busy?
Harry, I'm your guidance counselor. I'm never too busy for you kids.
Well, I just need to know about Selective Service.
Well, sure. Let's see, Harry. You're about 13 now.
Mr. Hudson, I'll be 18 tomorrow.
Really? That's great, Terry. Have a lollipop.
No, thanks.
Okay, then. Have a nice day.
Mr. Hudson?
Harry! Hi, how are you? Can I help you?
Yes, can you tell me about Selective Service?
Sure, you have to register within 18 days of your 30th birthday.
Wait, you mean within 30 days of your 18th birthday? My birthday's tomorrow.
Really? Terry has a birthday tomorrow, too. Have a lollipop.
No, I just want to know where to register.
For what, Harry?
Selective Service, Mr. Hudson. I need to register for Selective Service.
You sure do. Good man. Don't you have a birthday tomorrow?
Yes, I do, but where do I go?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe a little birthday dinner might be nice.
Oh, no, to register.
Oh, the post office.
Thank you.
Don't forget to register within 30 days of your 18th birthday. Just stop by the post office and fill out a card. It's quick, it's easy, and it's the law.
You know, Terry, I just love helping you kids.
Mm-hmm.
1-800-572-8255 is our number to Swainsboro and talk to Effie. Good morning, Effie.
Good morning.
How you doing?
Pretty good. I've crippled arthritis, 87, still living in my house, had built 54 years ago.
Sound like you're still kicking high to me, Effie.
Yeah, that's what everybody tells me.
Well, good.
But I had a very unusual vacation that I don't know anybody else. I don't know other people that have had that privilege because it's to a private place.
Tell me about it.
It's St. Catherine's Island. You've heard of that?
No, where is that?
Out from Savannah, St. Catherine's Island.
St. Catherine's, okay, yeah. I know what you're talking about.
St. Catherine's.
Yeah.
Well, I owned a cottage down at Yellow Bluff for 20 years, and I've been a widow 24 years now. And about 30 years ago, I was down there, and a friend of, and I had an invitation to go and spend a few days on St. Catherine's Island, which is privately owned. And the mansion over there was first owned by the Declaration, one a man who was a signer of the Declaration of Independence.
Later, it
belonged to the Lifesaver King, the one that started all these lifesavers. I had always wanted to go there and see that mansion. I had been across the island on a chartered fishing trip to land somewhere else and go somewhere else, but I had not had a chance to tour the mansion.
Mm-hmm.
And this caretaker, you can only go there by invitation from one of the caretakers or some of that family, and they were from one of the northern states. And his heirs owned that now. So I had this privilege of being invited. Of course, we got in a small boat at Yellow Bluff across small rivers and big rivers and across St. Catherine Sound. And then we landed on St. Catherine's Island and spent a few days at one of the caretakers' homes. And we got to tour the island and tour the home and everything. And it is a beautiful place. Wild deer, turkeys, and everything over there. And we could get up in the morning and walk to the place to fish. I've been a great fisherman. So we just had a real interesting time, and it was so interesting. They had furniture from all over the world in that mansion, and special made drapes for that company, and special made ties for him with lifesavers on them, all that stuff, and it was very interesting. And those people don't get their mail but once a week. They get in a large boat and go and dock at Half Moon River, a big river, and there's a carport with all their cars parked there, and they get in there and go once a week and buy their groceries, and there's a little house built over there to put their mail in for the week.
How far is that off the coast, Effie?
Well, it's not too far, I don't think, but because one in crossing St. Catherine's Sound, and looking one way, you can't see anything but water.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very interesting. It's kind of rough going across the sound and everything. The only thing my friend and I, we went to bed that night, I said, you know, I've always wanted to come over here and see this mansion and everything, but you know, when I lie down here at night, know I can't get away from here if I get ill or something except by boat or plane, it kind of worries me. She said, hush, I was all right till you said that.
Yeah, being on an island bothers me, too. I'm talking about even with one as big as Hawaii bothers me.
Oh, I know. With this one, you could go all the way across it, you know.
I'd just go get in my car and go on home, folks.
I felt kind of uneasy about it, but I did enjoy the few days I spent over there, and it was a rare thing because, like I said, nobody gets invited over there except by the caretaker or the people that owned it.
Do they generate their own electricity and everything?
I think they do. They have a sawmill over there and everything. They have all kind of business going on over there. And the caretakers get up and go to work at 7 o'clock in the morning. And the caretaker we stayed with, his wife had to stay over on at Yellow Bluff on land to send the children to school. And he was the only one with us over there that few days. And
how about mosquitoes at night, Effie?
Yeah, I imagine they were bad. We didn't get out at night. So
play that one smart. Good enough.
But anyway, the plants are beautiful and it's just...
Your comment cards. Those of you who have bought allergy-free electrostatic air filters and filled in the comment card. We get a lot of them here. There's a whole bin. I just pick one out. Here's one from Lawrence Hardix. Lawrence noticed a cleaner breathing environment within 20 minutes of installation. This air filter will get rid of everything in your air. Mildew and spore and dander and dust. And you know, this time of year is the time that you need the allergy-free electrostatic air filter because of the bloody dust. Joe McHugh says, no more sneezing in the house, just out of it, and less dust everywhere. See, thank you, Joe. Just happened to fit in perfectly. Here's what you do to order an allergy-free electrostatic air filter. It's what McKee did. Cost you $59.95, 10-year warranty, 30-day money-back guarantee. Not one question to ask, nothing to hook up. You just slide it in like your old filter. Get the filter size in a credit card. You hose it off to clean it, too. and call 1-800-324-4AIR. 1-800-324-4247's the number.
You're listening to the best of Ludlow Porch. Stay tuned for more following the news on AM 750 WSB.
Every 6 minutes, 10 times an hour, Atlanta's morning news updates weather and traffic. AM 750 WSB, depend on it.
WSB Atlanta.
News Talk Radio, AM 750 WSB, time and time, 4 o'clock.
AP Network News, I'm Sean Anderson. All aboard. The Bill Clinton-Al Gore bus caravan hits the road again today as the Democratic ticket tries to recapture the excitement of last month's post-convention coach ride. The story from AP Stelma Lebrecht.
Starting in St. Louis, Bill Clinton and Al Gore are beginning this bus tour where the first one ended. That one, which began in New York, was seen as such a success that Clinton campaigners want to repeat it. They believe using both men on the ticket to draw crowds and making stops in small-town America is the way to get the Democratic message out. This tour is to head north up the Mississippi River with stops including Hannibal, Missouri, Burlington and Bettendorf, Iowa, Prairie du Chien, Wisconsin, and finally the Twin Cities of Minneapolis, St. Paul. Family Brecht, AP Network News, with a Clinton campaign in Little Rock, Arkansas.
President Bush is also on the stump today. He'll be visiting New York and Nevada. Yesterday, the president told USA Today editors that he's ready for a tough re-election fight.
I'm getting geared up to take my case to the American people, and I'm convinced that some of that will turn around, not all of it. But nobody likes to be constantly criticized, and yet the American people are fair, and so it'll sort itself out.
Bush told the editors that Bill Clinton is a man he likes, but it's time to go after Clinton's record. Tip O'Neill once said that all politics are local. It's a lesson that Republican Congressman Guy Vanderjagt of Michigan may have forgotten. Vanderjagt, who's the powerful chairman of the National Republican Congressional Committee, lost his party primary last night to political first-timer Peter Hoekstra.
The people in this country are looking for good government, and that's what they're voting for, good, responsible government. And that was the foundation for my campaign.
Hoekstra argued that Vanderjagt had lost touch with the home folks. As head of his party's congressional committee, Vanderjagt held sway over money and resources for candidates. GOP Congressman Dick Nichols has lost his bid for a second term in his party's primary. A couple of Democratic senators are accusing the Bush administration of being too slow in reacting to the civil war in what used to be Yugoslavia. Astronauts aboard the space shuttle Atlantis have not been having much luck deploying a satellite that's attached to a 12.5-mile cord. The cord got stuck, so crew members will try again today. NASA has also decided to extend the shuttle mission until Saturday. This is AP Network News. Some tense moments for 270 people aboard a Continental Airlines DC-10 leaving Honolulu. Officials say an engine caught fire last night as the plane took off for Guam, but the pilot was able to extinguish the blaze, dump the fuel, and return to the airport. No one was hurt. Delta has decided to chop fall and winter fares on transatlantic flights by 30%. Three other airlines will follow suit. Brush fires continue to plague the West. In northern Nevada, a 20,000-acre wildfire forced the evacuation of 100 people in the gold mining town of Jarbridge. Steve Frady is a spokesman for the State Division of Forestry.
It's extremely rough terrain. It's mountainous canyons. The town of Jarbridge itself sits in a canyon bottom. And from the bottom to the top of the ridge is approximately 1 mile. Types of vegetation up there are sagebrush, grass, mountain mahogany, white fir, and a lot of weeds. And again, it's extremely dry in that area.
Fires are also burning in Oregon, Idaho, and California. San Francisco supervisors are